A big development has taken place when it comes to augmenting the capabilities of the US Navy in the realm of hypersonic weapons. In August 2023, the guided missile destroyer USS Zumwalt DDG-1000 arrived at Huntington Ingalls Industries HII, Mississippi Shipyard to begin a two-year process to install hypersonic missile tubes. The warship has now been put back in the water after undergoing 14 months of work. The launchers will eventually fire intermediate-range conventional prompt strike IRCPS hypersonic missiles. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the Zumwalt-class is on its way to getting a major lethality boost with the IRCPS system. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Zumwalt-class destroyers have 80 Mark 57 cells protected by the Peripheral Vertical Launch System (PVLS), as well as two 150mm guns. Each Mark 57 can carry a single SM-2 or SM-6 long-range surface-to-air missile, ASROC anti-submarine rocket torpedo, or up to 4 Evolved Sea Sparrow short-range surface-to-air missiles. Importantly, they can also carry Tomahawks. The two 155mm advanced gun systems were supposed to be capable of engaging targets with precision-guided shells at ranges of up to 60 miles or 95 kilometers. The long-range land attack projectile, or LRLAP, the precision-guided shell that would arm the ship's guns, saw cost escalation from $50,000 a round to $800,000 a round. The U.S. Navy, for this reason, canceled LRLAP. U.S. Navy decided to rearm the class and shift the focus of Zumwalt from close to shore to blue water engagement with the installation of hypersonic weapons. As per reports, the U.S. Navy has determined that the hull can accommodate 4 87-inch missile tubes. Each of these tubes would be able to house 3 IRCPS missiles. That means Zumwalt will be armed with a total of 12 of these missiles. Intermediate-range conventional prompt strike (IRCPS) is a conventional intermediate-range boost-glide hypersonic weapon system. The CPS all-up round missile includes a two-stage solid rocket motor booster and a common hypersonic glide body (CHGB) containing a kinetic energy projectile warhead. The U.S. Department of Defense has been developing the CHGB so that it will serve as the base of its offensive hypersonic missile. CHGB will be used by the different services of the U.S. military, Army, and Navy. U.S. Navy was put in charge of developing the CHGB. The design of the common hypersonic glide body is based on the previously developed alternate re-entry system, which was tested in the early 2010s as part of the Army's Advanced Hypersonic Weapon Program. The alternate re-entry system was itself based on the Sandia Winged Energetic Re-entry Vehicle Experiment, or SWERV, prototype developed by Sandia National Laboratories in the 1980s. CHGB's dimensions are common across the Navy and Army and have been developed keeping in mind many aspects. In the IRCPS system, the glider will be launched to extremely high altitudes using a ballistic missile, then separate from the carrier missile and will skim back to the Earth towards its intended target attaining hypersonic speed. Hypersonic speed means the object exceeds Mach 5, which is 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. The glider will also be able to maneuver in flight, unlike traditional ballistic missiles, and is much faster than a typical cruise missile. The combination of high speed and the ability to take an unpredictable path will make the missile a lethal weapon. There's no dependable way to intercept this kind of weapon at present. Each service of the U.S. military will use the CHGB as the base while developing individual weapon systems such as launchers capable of firing weapons from land or sea. The IRCPS missile is being seen as providing an alternative to nuclear weapons for strategic retaliatory strikes. HII has stated that these ships' upgrades are not yet complete, but Zumwalt's eventual return to the fleet with hypersonic missile capability could signal the beginning of a potential redemption arc for this controversial class of ships. The second Zumwalt-class ship, USS Michael Mansour, DDG-1001, and the third, USS Lyndon B. Johnson, DDG-1002, will also have this upgrade. The U.S. Navy is looking to have all three ready to go by fiscal year 2028. By equipping the Zumwalt-class with the IRCPS missile, the U.S. Navy aims to enhance the utility of a $7.5 billion warship that, despite being a testbed for numerous innovations, has often been criticized as an expensive misstep. Despite its tarnished reputation, the three Zumwalt-class destroyers remain the Navy's most technologically advanced surface warships. These ships feature a lot of innovations, including electric propulsion, an angular stealth design to reduce radar visibility, a wave-piercing hull, automated fire and damage control systems, and a composite deckhouse that conceals radar and other sensors. The Zumwalt class can generate an impressive 78 megawatts of electricity, enough to power nearly 10,000 average American homes. Even at a cruising speed of 20 knots, the class retains a substantial 58 megawatts of reserve power. Thanks to its cutting-edge integrated power system, the destroyers have sufficient energy reserves to support next-generation radar systems and directed energy weapons. So, if the Zumwalt class can be equipped with an IRCPS system, it will make these warships one of the most lethal surface combatants.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.